Thank you very much for attending my lightning talk on CI/CD and open infrastructure. It's not specifically not only for OpenStack, it is for any platform that you would like to try Kubernetes. Also in the future it will be for Bare Metal, which is we're very much looking forward to. At the moment we are initially we focused on OpenStack because it's some known quantity for us. We've been doing OpenStack deployments for a long time. I've been with Mirantis for almost 6 years now, and I've seen OpenStack grow from something that people had in their data center with a 10, 15 node installation with to just try it out, to dip their toes into the water, to something that a lot of major companies, I have guests here from Volkswagen, for instance, and for other, I see other familiar faces that they are using for their infrastructure. OpenStack, of course, is a very complex environment. It takes a long time. If you would ever try to manually install an OpenStack cluster, you would find out that this is something that you do not want to do. I have, at the very beginning at Mirantis, we actually did installations manually, and we found very quickly that this was not the way to go. So we came up with a tool named Fuel and Mirantis OpenStack that became the sort of envelope of Fuel. Fuel was a deployment tool. It was based on Puppet. It was not CI/CD, and this is not what this talk is about. But the limitations became obvious eventually. One of the things was that we only focused on deploying OpenStack, and this is not enough anymore in today's world. If you want to, you build an environment, and it will change over time. It will evolve. It will grow. It will be upgraded to the next version. And if you try to do this with an environment that has just been deployed with a deployment tool, you have the choice between scripts, script horizon, like the event horizon with the black hole where it starts pulling in all the scripts that you possibly have written, and it will demand newer and better scripts all the time. And you know where that eventually ends. Nobody knows how it works anymore. Nobody is willing to touch the code base, because if you touch it in the wrong way, then you will inadvertently create something that that will simply not work anymore, and nobody will know how to fix it. You have a lot of tribal knowledge, which has been a problem with that quite a few of our customers encountered, not only if people leave the company, which is obviously a rather big thing if a key person leaves the company, but also if you are running a 24-hour environment, in the morning somebody makes a change, in the evening the night shift comes in, they have no idea that the change was there, something all of a sudden doesn't work anymore. What do you do? You cannot go with your scripted environment, you cannot go back and see what was done. You do not have a universal source of truth of what was done. And if you ask a software developer, they are not going to let you have a major project with just the environment. Yeah, we are editing a file here and just putting it back into the code base. That simply does not work. We have human error. We have diverging configurations, which is also a major problem that we have encountered in multiple customers, that changes were made, but not to all the nodes. Eventually, you have incompatibilities. You have you get failures, and the failures are very, very difficult to diagnose. So, if we want to apply CI/CD to an open infrastructure, of course, the very first thing that we need is a code base. And this code base has to be, it can be something arbitrary. We are, at Mirantis, we are using SaltStack for this, because SaltStack has a very rich feature set for controlling OpenStack environments with Salt, but obviously that alone isn't enough. SaltStack itself is just, again, a way to script things, to make things happen in a scripted form. So on top of that, we have to have a methodology for automated code deployment You have to be able to take the changes that you made in your code base, in your salt stack code base, and transfer it into your actual environment, ideally even into your staging environment, test it in the staging environment, and put it back into, put it into a production environment. You should have automated testing, of course, and the most important piece is no manual interaction with the cloud components. If you have to log into KVM, into a controller node to make a change manually, then you are already getting to the back to the point where you have the diverging configs, where you have the risk of things not working right because somebody made the change only to controller one but didn't do it on controller two and three. And it works for a while because they restarted only controller one, and then later on if there's a failover between a service on controller one and the controller two, then all of a sudden it stops working. And then of course we have to have continuity across individuals, which means we will need to be able to see what the people in, that were ahead of us in time did to the environment. So I already showed this morning at a different talk. This is the environment that we eventually came up with. It's the whole environment is called MCP, but it is fully based on open source components. We have the well-known Garrett Jenkins environment for CI/CD. We make changes to the code base by checking changes in Garrett and having them approved by the appropriate approvers. Obviously, you can also set it up so you can approve your changes yourself, but that's kind of not the point. If you're making changes yourself and approving them, then you are violating that 4 eyes principle where you have to have someone else make sure that what you did was not accidentally mistyped. Look at the piece of code and try to find a missing semicolon. This is that's exactly it. So reclass in between takes the human readable code changes and creates a set of intermediary files that are actually used to implement the changes in the environment. And you have the configurations that are coming out of that. In the code base, you will find generated directories where entities are that you are not supposed to touch. And then you have the Jenkins, which has a set of pipelines. If you want to know more about that, come by our booth. We have a demo set up that we can show where you can see what a pipeline like this looks like and what it's used for. And then the deployment with the salt formulas into staging and then into production. So from the field, this is something that I wanted to talk about a little bit. We have quite a few customers who have both, who have MOS-based clouds and who have MCP-based clouds. And the universal feedback has been pretty much from everyone who has been working on both environments is that MOS was great for what it was supposed to be doing, but it was not complete. It was not doing what it, or it would not help you operating the cloud after day one. MCP has been different. We have obviously had a maturing product. We had in the very beginning, the very first version of MCP was, let's say, a little bit finicky, but by now we are at a point where we universally find that dealing with MCP in any given situation is much easier than dealing with the old way of doing things that was not CI/CD based. And one thing that I would like to highlight especially is supportability. We have time and again, we have failures at customer sites. We used to spend a lot of time just trying to figure out where the problem might possibly lie. MCP helps a lot with that because you can actually go back into Garrett and see what changes have been made over time, especially changes that have been made by a previous shift, and find at least a set of potential issues that you can easily address. Sometimes there will still be something that you will have to search the old-fashioned way, but in most cases, or in very many cases, you will find that it is much easier to be able to look at what has changed and also be able to tell us what has changed. Nothing has changed. So you will be able to find a fault much faster. I'm out of time, unfortunately. If you would like to know more, please stop by the booth. And I hope that you found the talk useful. And thank you very much for attending.